Welcome to the learning section of Accounts Receivable. Your first question may well be, what is accounts receivable? Well, many people use the word accounts receivable to mean the customer records. However, the name became synonymous with customer records because originally, accounts receivable really was and is a general ledger account in the chart of accounts that's equal to the total balances of all customers combined. When we look at a typical chart of accounts in QuickBooks, we see that the accounts have names, and each account name also has an account type. The name is only important for us. The name is not important for QuickBooks. You can name an account any name you want, and QuickBooks will let you spell it any way you want. However, if the account type is chosen as accounts receivable, this tells QuickBooks that this specific account is the account that will represent the total money that all customers combined owe to Holden or owe to the company. For example, let us imagine you had a customer named Alan, and let us imagine at this moment Alan owes $100. Let us also imagine you have a customer named Betty, who at this moment owes us $200. And of course, we have a third customer named Candy, who at this moment owes us $300. That means at this very same moment, the general ledger account accounts receivable should equal $600. Now, this means that when we have a transaction that causes any customer's balance to go up, the general ledger account accounts receivable goes up by the same amount. Whenever we have any transaction that makes any customer's balance go down, it means for that same transaction, accounts receivable in the chart of accounts will also go down. Now, while we're on the subject, we might as well mention what is account payable. Account payable is the same idea, but the opposite direction. Account payable is an account in the chart of accounts that represents the total money that we, the business, owe to all of our vendors. The balance of account payable will be the combined amount that we owe to all of the individual vendors put together. For example, let us imagine that we owe to a vendor called Verizon $200. And at the same moment, we owe to another vendor called UPS $400. And at this very same moment, we owe to a third vendor named Staples $600. Well, if that's the case, that means that the general ledger account payable in the chart of accounts should have a balance of $1,200.